on to Pimlico for the Preakness. Matt, last week we were a little worried that we wouldn't have any of the top names challenging the impressive unbeaten Kentucky Derby winner justifying the Preakness. But Chad Brown, E5 Racing and Stone Street Stables say, no, we are going to run Good Magic, the Kentucky Derby runner-up, the Breeders' Cup Juvenile winner, the two-year-old champion, Good Magic, in the Preakness. And Matt, I think that's nothing but good news.
It is good news. It looks like we're going to have a field of eight that is made up of four horses from the Derby and four Preakness new shooters.
Oh, there's that new shooter thing again. Hey, Matt, if you don't mind, let's run down the field real quick. I made my own morning line, as I always do for these big races. I have Justify It 1-2, Matt. Good Magic 3-1. No one else is under 10-1, and there's only one horse at 10-1. That's Quip. Bravazo, Lone Sailor, Tenfold at 20-1. And then we drop down to Sporting Chance and Diamond King at 30-1. So my question to you is, Justify 1-2, is he worth that kind of low odds?
Well, Brian, I don't know. Is any horse worth those kind of odds when it comes to betting strategy? But I think your morning line is pretty realistic. I thought Justify might be somewhere between 2-5 and 3-5, which is exactly as you have it. When you go back and look at the past performances of his trainer, Bob Baffert, I guess maybe it's not such a bad price, considering that Mr. Baffert has never lost the Preakness with one of his Kentucky Derby winners.
Justify is 4-4 lifetime. Baffert's 4-4 lifetime in the Preakness after winning the Derby. He's won 6 Preaknesses total, Matt. Obviously, Justify is in good hands and just appears to be doing very well, or that's everything we're hearing out of the Baffert camp. Baffert was out at Churchill Downs to see the star running, and he liked what he saw. Apparently, any issues with that hoof, whether it were the scratches or the heel bruise, looks like Justify is back to fit as a fiddle, and Baffert is happy, just like he was before the Kentucky Derby. And speaking of the clear second choice, the Derby runner-up, obviously, Matt, I think if Chad Brown is choosing to run Good Magic on 2 weeks rest in the Preakness, it says a lot about how this horse continues to thrive this spring. We saw how happy Brown was after the Bluegrass, knowing his horse was doing so well. He did nothing but well at Churchill Downs. He's already out at Pimlico, a sloppy Pimlico track this morning, galloping, getting a feel for the track. But obviously, Brown must be tickled pink with how Good Magic has come out of the Kentucky Derby. Otherwise, he doesn't run him.
Yeah, I think that's true. And then just jumping back to Justify for a minute. I mean, I think when you brought up those heel problems and all the different stories that we heard about it, I think it's only fair that we bring that up and mention it to the fans, because, I mean, it's certainly that. That little bit of a question mark is lingering in the back of my head, especially when the gates open and they get into heated competition again. Going to Good Magic, I agree with what you said about Chad Brown. I don't think he's interested. I don't think that he feels like the mile and a half in the Belmont Stakes is a particularly good fit for Good Magic. And since he is doing well, why not take another shot at the Triple Crown right now in the Preakness?
Right, and I think it's a good thing for racing to have a big challenger for Justify. I'm a little surprised that Curlin, son of Curlin, out of a hard-spun, stakes-winning hard-spun mare, that Brown's not high in Good Magic going 12 furlongs, but hey, he knows a lot more about Good Magic and training horses than I do, so I'll defer to him. And certainly Good Magic is the horse who looks like the best challenger for Justify in here, Matt. But there are other horses. Quip, I like the decision. I said this before the Derby, not to run in the Kentucky Derby, to wait for the Preakness. Obviously, this horse is developing for the former assistant to Bill Mott, and he seems to be doing really well. I think he's going to be the clear third choice off those wins in the Tampa Bay Derby and I should say a win in the Tampa Bay Derby and a second place in the Arkansas Derby. A couple others that interest me, Bravazo, a friend reminded me how far he ran in the Derby. He had one of the longest trips around the track that day at Churchill Downs, so his sixth place finish was even better than it looks. And awesome again, Lucas, we've seen this story before with Oxbow running a decent Derby and then putting it all together for the Preakness. And then I'm intrigued by Tenfold, a horse who's lightly raced, but I think probably a horse who could develop into something very good.
Yeah, I agree with you, Brian. And as the fans should know, when it comes to the Preakness, it usually is the Derby horses that take most of the betting money. They take the bulk of the action, as they well should. I mean, to me, it seems like Quip is a horse that seems to be getting ignored a little bit and has done very little wrong in his career. I also like Tenfold. Steve Asmussen is high on the horse. Let me talk a little bit more about him. He won his first two races at Oaklawn in the late winter, and then in the Arkansas Derby, he ran fifth. Asmussen has said that the horse has been doing extremely well since the Arkansas Derby. I think he's a horse that has a lot of talent. His early races were impressive, had good speed figures. This is a horse that could be improving and maybe is one of the new shooters that can finish in the money. Bravazo certainly outran his odds of 69-1 in the Derby when he rallied to get sixth place.
Right, Matt. And in fact, with Bravazo, if you look at that Derby and you look at the feet run during the race, it was a very good performance. And you throw out that Louisiana Derby, for whatever reason, he didn't run in the Louisiana Derby. You've got a very interesting horse. So I'm with you there. Bravazo and Tenfold are my two long shots. Tenfold's only run three times. Folks, I know I've said that before the Kentucky Derby with the eventual Kentucky Derby winner, but I still think this is a tough jump up for Tenfold. But I'm with Matt. In fact, I said this a few weeks ago. I think Tenfold is a horse that will develop into a nice horse. The ones we haven't mentioned too much yet, Lone Sailor ran a decent enough Derby, eighth place. I'm not sure I like him as much in the Preakness. Originally, I thought there might be more speed in here, Matt. It doesn't look as speedy as it did possibly a week ago. Sporting Chance, I think, just has too many things to overcome with himself. Basically, he's a horse who makes trouble for himself, and he's got some talent, but hard to see him putting it all together for the Preakness. And Diamond King, I think, is just a nice horse, Parks-based, kind of a mid-Atlantic horse there, but probably just a cut below. So for me and my betting, I will be using Bravazo and Tenfold a little bit with the favorites and see if we can't get something done. But Matt, I can't get away from Justify as my top pick and Good Magic as my second pick.
Yeah, that's all very logical, Brian. And like you said, Diamond King's a nice horse. Hey, he's won four races in his six starts, but as you said, most of them were all in the Mid-Atlantic region. You know, he was mentioned a few times for starts on the Derby Trail at Aqueduct, but they always opted to go back and run at Laurel. And in his victory, his speed figures are just a notch below what the Derby horses have done. And Sporting Chance is just a horse that seems to be a head case right now. Even in even since the Derby the other day, he was scheduled to have a final breeze, and they took him to the track, and several times he refused to kick it into high gear there. So I can't feel real confident about Sporting Chance.
I'm with you, Matt. That's the Preakness field, folks. Justify, deserving favorite, unbeaten Kentucky Derby winner. Will we be talking Triple Crown at this time next week? We very well may be. Good Magic, two-year-old champion, ran a very good race in the Kentucky Derby to be second, offers a big challenge again in the Preakness. And then Matt and I are both saying Quip, Bravazo, and Tenfold as horses to possibly get in the mix a little bit as Preakness long shots.